General Motors was founded on Wednesday, September the 16th, 1908. Over 100 years of automotive activity later, it is one of the world's largest car and truck manufacturers. But the road has not always been smooth. In this program, how GM transformed its IT function to help drive its recovery. Alejandro Martinez Galindo is both board member at General Motors UK and VP and CIO for General Motors Europe. He's better placed than most to explain the company's technology transformation, one of the engines that powered its journey from bankruptcy. I asked him what strategies he used to affect change and how GM is using IT to solve real business issues.
The first element, you need to be able to move your IT at the speed of business. This is very important. Non-traditional IT is important. The business is moving very fast. Automotive company is extremely competitive. First, you need speed. Second, we have to transform the IT organization into the new GM model, which means you need to be nimble, fast, and cost effective. You need to make sure that you focus on value creation. And I think this is very important, the value of IT. Now, you asked me about specific examples. In the past, it used to take us 48 months for the vehicle development process. Based on the new way to run our business, plus all the tools that we have implemented, name it, map data, virtual reality, crash simulation, aerodynamics, ergonomics, etc., etc., etc. What I can say is that we have been able to reduce substantially the vehicle development program. This brings tremendous savings and also speed for business. Second, if I go to the supply chain, we have developed tools that improve to give us better visibility. Second, we can sense and respond to market condition, so we can optimize the sourcing of our vehicles, the sourcing of our materials, but also we can optimize substantially our working capital. The third element, if I go to the manufacturing plants, automotive industry relies on heavy, fast manufacturing processes. So you need real-time information. And we have gone completely to mobilize the information that we have in our manufacturing plants. What is very important, we need to reduce the downtime turn time in the plants, and also we need to be able to respond to any potential issues in the plant by mobilizing all the systems and all information in the tablet devices and mobile phones. The people in the factory can react to any potential incident, and at the end of the day, speed matters. If I go to other elements of the business, I can say that in the paint shops, for instance, we're using business analytics in order to understand better based on the weather conditions and also the conditions of the manufacturing on that day, what is the right mix, what is the right balancing. So we really mine the data in order to make sure that we caliber proper the paint shops, so at the end of the day, our quality improves. And I can go on and on across the different processes. What is clear, this IT transformation touches all the elements of the business, because at the end of the day, it's about providing value to the business.
What was your breakthrough project, the thing that enabled you to demonstrate the kind of business value that IT can bring to GM?
Let me give you a specific example of what we are doing in order to drive revenue. The first topic is in order to attract the commitment from the business, we create a very strong partnership with Chief Marketing Officer, and we decide to find ways jointly to drive more revenue, the bottom line results. That is a very complex enterprise, so we have a program that analyzes, that leverage several aspects of the business on technologies, you name it, CRM, lead management, big data, analytics. So we use technologies in our websites and all the touch points with the consumers to analyze the both of the customers, to understand and be able to sense and respond to the specific market conditions. Through applying a lot of learnings, big data, et cetera, in the lead management programs, we have been able to generate substantial results. And these are bottom line results. These are results in car sales. What is very interesting is when you go to the the building where these groups are working, based on the partnership that we have created with the chief marketing officer, you cannot identify which guys work for IT, which guys work for marketing. So it's one of the programs that we are very proud of, because at the end of the day, has hit bottom line results, and more to come on that space.
Services like cloud, you know, this kind of modern technology platforms, how are they helping you to achieve the goal? Are the things you're doing now possible because of things like cloud, or is it just all about an attitude change?
I mean, cloud, like other different technologies, you name it, mobile analytics, et cetera, are part of a very important tool set for every CIO. In the case specific of cloud, this based on the size and economics of our company, we have gone through private cloud. Makes sense based on economies of scale for us. So first, cloud has been helping us to rationalize our data center footprint, which is very important. Second element, we have seen improvements in the way that we protect our intellectual property, and second, security. I think that those are important elements. Now, cloud has been an enabler, and I think this is the most important business benefit, to help us to globalize the application. I think it's very important. In an enterprise of this size, of GM, you need to have common global solutions. And cloud has been a major enabler for us, because now we are able to reach points and geographies that we never have been able to do it before, or they have local unique applications in a computer center or small data infrastructure and so on. But now, by leveraging this kind of technologies, we can really gain speed and, second, commonality. At the end of the day, this matters because our structural cost is improves.
How did you transform the IT organization that way? How did you get the IT people thinking about the business?
I think this is a very important topic. I saw recently a very interesting statistic that says that around 50% of the global capital investment in the enterprise goes to IT. So why the executives, senior executives, are so skeptic about the value of IT? I think it's a matter of communications, and I think it's a matter of positioning properly the IT organization. If you see yourself as the CIO, just focus on basic services, you're going to be considered as perhaps chief information officer. I'm sorry for the term. You just focus on cost. Now, if you really understand the maturity model of engagement with senior executive and what the CEO and the board is expecting, and again, it's a maturity level that goes from services to the engagement and value creation. If you understand what is important for the board, I think you're starting to make that change. And again, important elements. It's not about IT, it's about business, it's about enablers. So what is very important, you need to explain your strategy in business terms. By the way, in our organization, we don't talk about IT and business alignments, because that would send a connotation of distance. The IT is the technical arm of the business. So you need to share the same objectives, either revenue, working capital, et cetera, et cetera. You need to have your same objectives. You cannot be a silo organization. And another important element is you need to quantify everything. Everything needs to be, or the project that you're going to be doing needs to be quantified in terms of revenue, of cost, etc., etc. You need to be able to articulate the value that IT is giving to the business. And I think that's very, very important. And this is where, based on what I have observed, a lot of CIOs are struggling in how to communicate the value of IT. And I think this is very important. But this is not an annual exercise. You need to measure yourself on a regular basis. On a monthly basis, you need to communicate to your colleagues what is the payback on the investments that they are receiving as part of investing in IT. So it's, again, you need to understand the maturity model and drive the change. I think that's very important. And everything starts in thinking differently.
But of course it was easy, everybody were doing it and everybody isn't. What are the most common obstacles you've encountered?
I think on today's economical environment where all the businesses are under pressure, you can fall into one of the traditional traps where we need to cut costs, we need to cut costs, we need to cut costs, or delay investments, and et cetera, et cetera. I think it's very important for the CIO to have a clear vision, consistency, and again, articulate the way that you're providing value to the business. Otherwise, you're going to be falling into one of the traditional, let's say, traditional enterprise IT points of the view, and at the end of the day, you're not going to be able to transform the enterprise. Now, if you really would like to take advantage of the momentum that also economical crisis brings also opportunities, if you identify jointly with your business partners what is key, what are the areas that you can invest in leverage IT technology either to improve, generate a competitive advantage or close a gap with your competitors. This is where you need to focus your entire attention.
Do you have any, I suppose, advice for, you know, for people watching this broadcast? How can they define and deliver a roadmap to manage their enterprise IT transformation based on your own experience?
So the first topic is starting with the fundamentals. Everything is about the business, it's not about IT. I think this is very important. Second, you need to understand based on the market conditions or your industry or your business, you need to understand where you are in the maturity model of the relationship. If you are a cost center, if you are engaged, there's a clear way that will take you step by step. You cannot avoid any of the steps. If you don't have credibility from your business partners, you're not going to be able to move to the next level. So it's very important to understand where you are and develop a very clear roadmap that will take you step by step toward the value creation or what they call the innovation CIO.